Most people have now heard about the incredible things that are happening with artificial intelligence and being able to generate things from text. Just by entering a simple string of commands, we can get the artificial intelligence to generate things for us. So we've been doing a lot of tutorials on Blender. I thought, let's see what we can get our artificial intelligence to do. Now I'm going to do an iterative process on this over several tutorials to show what we can possibly do. So, and it's best to do that because training or figuring out the best prompts for what you're trying to accomplish is time consuming and should be done trial and error. So what we're going to do today is use Blender Script, which is a Python based scripting tool set, and we're going to see if we can't get ChatGPT from OpenAI to create a simple sphere moving up and down. That's all we're shooting for this very first tutorial. So I've already opened up OpenAI's chat program. Sign up for this. Right now it's in free trial so that you can do some incredible things. So using the ChatGPT from OpenAI, let's try giving it a simple command to create a sphere and tell it to move that sphere or animate that sphere moving up and down. So select our area, and I've already, there we go. And let's see what it creates. And so it's breaking it down into the important steps. We're going to have a scene with 60 frames. And we'll create the object. Now normally we'd put this import math at the very top of the program. Okay, and so it even gives some directions on how to make to modify the program if you want it to go longer, faster, change the radius of it. You can adjust all of that. So that's pretty cool. Let's copy all of this into Blender and see what happens. So I'm going to do copy code, go to scripting. I'm going to create a new script called sphere move and start pasting these in. There we go. And let's run. Looks like we have an error. Yes, on line 9. Originally, when it was creating the sphere, it was using a size variable instead of a radius variable. Let's see if that fixes our problem. Looks like it is now created. Let's jump back over here to layout. And let's get rid of this cube, because that's in the way. And see what happens with our playout. There we go. While far from perfect, the chat GPU did give us a basic script that could be modified, well, fixed, because it used the variable or the parameter size instead of radius for a sphere. Size would have been appropriate for other objects, but for a sphere, you're going to use radius. That's how it works. So, but in just a few seconds, I probably could have created the sphere and made it in the environment to run with just the same, with less effort. But like I said, this is a first step. ChatGPT is not going to give you perfect script, but if you know a little bit of scripting, if you understand how Blender works, you can create some things. So we're going to keep iterating on this and make more complex things. Make sure you like and subscribe so that you can follow along in this fascinating journey that we're on. This is a tool. This is not replacing 3D modelers. This is not replacing animators. It's a tool to help speed us up in what we are creating.